took a lot of trouble. Princess Silka.
I'm taking my own freedom, putting it in my song, singing loud and strong.
Sweet, sweet, sound, 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 and yes, intelligent. Your Princess Silka. Ciao, ciao, hola, and hello. What about marriage, Principessa? What about children, Principessa? What is there to be said? Okay, here you go. First and foremost, when you're with your partner, what you want to do is, what you want to do, what you long for to do. So, you know, it's love. You want to be gliding into each other's eyes, even in silence. For a while. That's love. You aim to just be together. Of course, it includes also silence. Silence and expressing with your inner wish. If you can't do that with a person, you're not on the right path. People who are abusive, they are evasive. You want excitement, and that you can get with love. People who are not including themselves in the equation, they don't feel excited, they feel dead. Yeah, maybe they propose stupid things like stupefaction, sensations, and stupidity. Enough said. Let me talk about Laura and her husband's name. I forgot. Yeah, the married couple with the business plan at hand. Did they have a pretty house? Oh, yes. And they had money and they renovated stuff. Oh, they're so pretty. Yeah, but she was insensitive and I think he was too. So one of the first things she actually admitted is, I don't really know why I got the house right here. Yes, and it was a very, very, very unfortunate feng shui situation she had there going for herself. It was on a cliff, so to speak, and had no garden. And everything inside couldn't really make up for it. These two, they were hanging on too tightly to the structures which they were, like, I don't know, raised, maybe? No, I was wondering whether the Lipuhanmi story is important. They invited me to lunch and they offered me, in Mexico, this dumb wine, Lipuhanmi, like it must be a special thing. It's not that they consumed it. I don't think they ever drank wine, especially not with food. But that they gave me German wine, being in Mexico, made no sense. So what I noticed is they were actually just us liquors. Yeah, well, I can say it not from afar. Lack of character and personality, not cultivated, and kind of idiotic as well. Insensitive, you can also call it. Maybe also because this is not really wine. It's like, it's so disgusting. It's like when you wash your dishes in water and you pour it into a bottle, it's disgusting too. On top. No, it's not expensive. I said it when I mentioned it last time. I wonder, since this is a thing which is given out in Mexico, how can there be such a large production when the country is so small? Well, it's garbage, that's what that is. It was completely inappropriate. I don't want to find words. Let's continue with them. I have something else to say. Maybe we're gonna close a circle here. So she had her a large amount of money each month. How convenient. Agreed upon her husband giving it to her. Because that's what she said. Okay, I'm gonna have a child with you, but I need so much money each month since I'm not giving up my job. So I don't have any income. I need to have liberty and freedom to spend money. So I will take care of the house. You don't need to worry about anything, she said. And she took it literally. House was impeccable. And here she did, made a little marvel in a little higher room. Not the attic, but maybe. Which she stuffed with toys for her daughter. I mean, she even had an... How old was she, daughter? Let me think about it. How old was the daughter? 2 years? She even had an electric car. I am not joking. I saw it with my own eyes. It was all very neat and clean. It had so many things. Yeah, it was like a paradise on steroids. A double steroids. That's where she spent her money with. And that alone would not be a bad thing if it would not have been accompanied with a little structure I noticed later in my life with my friend Rachel. Same structure, less toys. So she was sitting with her daughter and invited me, so I kind of wanted to hang out, right, talk. But she couldn't talk with me because she was constantly talking to her daughter, who was now in all these toys. What are you gonna do? What are you gonna do? What are you gonna paint with? I'm sorry, I'm always sounding way too sweet, imitating other people, because of course she wasn't sweet. What are you gonna paint now? Which color are you gonna use? Are you gonna do this? Oh, what about the other color? Now what are you gonna do? She was hovering over her daughter incessantly. Incessantly. She couldn't talk to me. Hovering. That was her policy. Hovering over her daughter. No time to think, no space to be. Horrible. Well, Rachel later I met in San Francisco, she did exactly the same. Particularly with the oldest, she had two. And these two girls, I don't know, Yaki said they're crazy. I don't exactly know what he meant. I think they turned out really derailed after a while and manipulated because they couldn't handle. So I didn't say anything. I looked and it was painful to me. Painstaking. And then she got pregnant. And the ultrasound told her that now she's gonna have a son. So next thing what she does, she builds a room in her house. And she says very firmly, yeah, well, I have to have a room for him because boys and girls is just not the same. I tell you why it's outrageous. Because she starts inviting a new member into her family, to her child, who is needy of her, of course, as children are, absolutely, and begins her mental structure, her mindset on separation. I do not agree. I don't think children need to have their own room. Quite the contrary. Girls and boys, it doesn't matter. Not in the beginning, not when they are small. If you have them, fine. But if you don't have them, it's actually a good thing to share. There is an age, of course, where that has to be changed. Which age might that be? Yeah, we might think about it. And of course it has to do with sexuality, but when did that happen? Yeah, I think 8 years max. But hopefully a little earlier. Hopefully much sooner. Hopefully 4 and 6, maybe. She did it all wrong. What she had to be doing is to invite now this new baby to her daughter's life, to include him, to let her know something is coming and here it is, and include her of being part of this adventure, participating in the new life. That's what she should have been doing, and she did exactly the contrary. When the child was born, Laura dropped all her attention from her daughter in a sudden, and now put all her attention on her newborn baby. So from having a hovering mother, the daughter had nobody. Abandoned. The cruelty about it is outrageous. So she acted out. And her father went and told, not me, because I didn't really talk with him. Yeah, talk, you know, piano guy. How do we call him? Person now. Said, I don't understand, the father said. Yeah, the Liebfrauenmilch, father and mother. I don't understand. Why is she upset? We bought her all the toys she needed. Exactly what my uncle Lothar had in mind. Buy, buy, buy stuff. I already had cheated on years before. I couldn't handle, I left her. I couldn't be friends with her. It was too much, way too much. It was so gruesome and cruel. No, I left her before her baby was born. the whole thing was just too much. And I bumped into them late years later, and you can clearly see they were like two different entities. Yeah, it beeps right there in Cuernavaca. They walked in, you can see the daughter and the son, two entities living in different worlds and probably in rivalry, in war, unhappy, and everything was kind of broken. It could have been that easy, but it was so hard for them to dig life because they were emotionless. So they meant business, but that was not a business, the family. Heaven knows I'm not like you, I'm not perfect. When he sees, will he leave?
Figure that, what better I wicked her on my stage, watching all